And welcome to the Edward J. Kaler Chapter of the National Honor Society's Annual Award Night. At this time, I would like to ask everyone to please stand and salute the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I'd like to start with a moment of silence in remembrance of National Honor Society member Kyla McGarry and alumni Christian Kudo and Devin Crosby. Thank you. Hello, I'm Bryce Garrettson, the president of National Honor Society. As I start my speech tonight, I want to thank everyone who is partaking in this event and has made it possible. Even under these awful circumstances, we have found a way to give recognition where it is well deserved. I think that is something that we all need to be appreciative of. During this time, these examples are even more imminent than ever and should be held with the utmost value. Now I'm here to talk to you about the future. Each and every one of you here will be soon closing one of the very big important door in your life and opening up an even bigger, more important, and completely new door. Each of you will have a very different plan or direction you will go in. As we move along to the next chapter of our lives, it does not mean that we must forget everything we've accomplished, learned, and experienced in this section of our lives, but rather to actually take with us and continue to practice and learn from it. National Honor Society, as you may know, is comprised of four main sections, pillars as we call them, as they support and are the foundation of the society. These are very important in terms of getting and staying in National Honor Society, but I believe that these are just introduction to the terms and getting and are valuable and essential in life beyond high school. As this is more your introduction to these characteristics and the rest of your life is where they need to be continuously applied, I will be addressing the four pillars, scholarship, service, character, and leadership, with how they are essential now and especially as we move forward in our lives. It is generally apparent why scholarship is important during school and academic endeavors. However, it may not be so clear why it would be necessary moving forward. However, this is where I stress the importance of the drive to learn more. This can help you throughout all of your life, no matter your age. The advantages of continually pursuing your questions are unmatched. As we all go forward in our lives, I advise you to always question things, as it will help you learn so much and make you a more well-rounded person. This is what scholarship is. It doesn't always have to be in correspondence with school or studying, but rather in everyday life while acquiring new knowledge in any way you can. Scholarship is the reason why we have so many amazing things, like technology, medicine, and more. Scholarship creates new ideas and helps foster creativity. Scholarship provides the foundation for innovation and helps us grow as a society and move forward in the right direction, along with learning from our past mistakes. Leading into our next pillar, we have service. Many of you think of this just as a requirement to get into National Honor Society or as in order to graduate, but it is much beyond that. Service can be helping in your community, whether that be picking up trash at a local beach or helping donate to causes in need, especially right now with everything going on. These don't change as you get older, but there are also other forms that as you become a more serious member in society. It will become important for you to give back to the community so that the youth of the community may have the same opportunities as you did growing up, whether that be helping fundraise for a new public library or volunteering at a local youth organization. These are the things that help a community stay cohesive, strong, and make service critical. Moving forward to our next pillar, this would be character. Character is essentially what you do when no one is watching. It is these qualities and morals that define you as a character. I believe character is one of the most important things a person possesses. It is who you are. It is important now just as it will be important in the future. Character is not cheating even if you had the chance. Character is helping a struggling classmate no matter the situation. The same thing goes for when you make your way into your workplace. Are you going to take advantage of your coworkers or your employer? This character is vital in being the best version of yourself. If you have a reputation of being lazy and slacking, how is that going to look when you try and get a new job and the employer asks for a recommendation from your past job? This all takes into account your morals and why it is important to take pride in your own character. The final pillar is leadership. This pillar is very important and valuable. As we all go along throughout life, we will all lead at some point or another, whether you want to or not. It may be in the classroom, the field, the court, or the hallways. You may not even know, as you could be a leader to your little sibling, cousin, or anyone in your presence. This is why it is always important to carry yourself as a leader, as you never know who you are impacting and how you're making an impression on them. The same goes even more so as we get older, maturing from young adults to actual adults. There will only be more people looking to us for help, guidance, or just unconsciously mimicking us, whether that be academically, socially, or how we carry ourselves on a day-to-day basis. Furthermore, it is a good thing to be a leader as long as you are portraying a good overall message. Leaders are the people that change the way we do things. They are the innovators, motivators, and role models. And that quality is ready and inside of each and every one of you. No matter how much you'd think, it's not. Without leadership, we would have no inspiration, no change, and no progress in life. This is why leadership is so essential in everyday life, from sports and school as a kid to your workplace and social life as an adult. All of these attributes are just as essential now as they will be throughout the rest of your lives. As you move forward into our next chapter, I advise you, even though it may be scary and you may be nervous, that you be ready. To try new things, don't be closed-minded. I will leave you with this. The only constant in life is change, said a Greek philosopher by the name of Heraclitus. I know all of you have the drive, work ethic, and passion and ability to do great things in the next section of your life. However, it is a different time in our lives, where the circumstances are so like unlike any other. In a time with so much panic, chaos, and hatred, and uncertainty, I ask all you here listening to take a breath and be grateful for what you have. No one in the world could have known how to navigate through these times that we are going through, but as a strong community, nation, and human race, I truly believe we are capable of doing anything, and this is no exception. We as a class are in such a rare position. However, no matter how tough it has gotten or how unfortunate it was, we have still persevered and adapted in the best way possible. And I believe that is a feat in itself. I know we all have the ability to do great, amazing things. I wish you all the best of luck in your endeavors, and I am proud to call you my peers. Stay safe, spread peace, think positive. You have a big future ahead of you. Thank you all for your time.
Mrs. Farias, we'd like to also thank our other officers who could not be here today because of our social distancing guidelines.
Yes, our Vice President, Mark Gagliardi, Secretary, Jacob Milan, Treasurer, Jessica Salomon, thank you so very much for everything you've done for us this year.
Thank you. We'd like to call our principal, Dr. Susan Brelsford, and Mrs. Jacuto for the next portion of our ceremony.
Good evening, class of 2020. We are certainly living in interesting times. Tonight marks one of my favorite nights of the year because it truly emphasizes what it means to be a reader. The end of this year was not at all how we had planned, but I felt it was important to continue with the tradition of tonight, even if it had to be virtual, because it celebrates you and the hard work, determination, and perseverance that you have put into your high school experience. And if we've learned nothing over the past few months, it is that our Somerset Berkley community continues, regardless of whether or not we are in the walls of this school. In the past few months, I've seen students and staff reach out to others in good times and in tragedy. And as difficult as this time has been, I have never been prouder to work here and be a part of this amazing school. Tonight, we celebrate the achievements that you have accomplished in the 4 years of your time here at Somerset Berkley. Your excellence in the classroom, on athletic fields, in music, and in your communities has prepared you to become the next generation of leaders. And there is no doubt in my mind that you will rise to the occasion and make a positive mark on our society. I want to extend my gratitude and thanks to you as students. You will always be a special class to me, as you will be the first graduating class under my time as principal of this wonderful school. The grace and kindness that you as a class have shown under the pressure of this current pandemic has truly been amazing. Thank you for being you, and continue to be the unique and wonderful people that you are. I truly cannot wait to hear what lies ahead for each and every one of you. I also want to thank your teachers and the entire staff of Somerset Berkley Regional High School, who did not give up on the process of education throughout this unprecedented time. They truly care about each and every one of you, and I know I speak for them when I say that we are proud of the young adults that you are. Additionally, I want to thank the communities of Somerset and Berkeley, including our school committee and Mr. Schoonover, and the central office staff, who continue to support and endorse every effort that we put forth to support the class of 2020 and the entire school community as we deal with this pandemic. Finally, to the class of 2020's parents and guardians, the final and most important thank you. Thank you for becoming pseudo teachers in the past few months, and thank you for sharing and trusting us with your children over the past 4 years. It is our honor and privilege to have taught your most precious commodity. Thank you for being champions for your children. Students, even if this is a little cheesy, at this time, would you please give your parents or guardians a gesture of thanks for all they have done and sacrificed for you? A hug, a fist bump, a little smile, just a little thanks to them for being in your corner. Once again, welcome to one of the most special nights of our school year. Congratulations to the recipients and honorees. We are so proud of each and every one of you. Please enjoy tonight's celebration. Thank you. And now I would like to introduce Mr. Jeffrey Schoonover, Superintendent of Schools, who has a few words for the graduates.
Good evening. My name is Jeff Schoonover, and I'm the very proud superintendent of the Somerset Berkley Regional School District. I want to welcome our families, faculty, administrators, other members of the SBRHS community, and most importantly, the distinguished members of the National Honor Society and the class of 2020. I want to extend my congratulations to you, the students being recognized this evening, for your achievements at Somerset Berkley. Next to graduation, this ceremony is always one of my favorite events of the year because we get to recognize students for their hard work and academic achievements through the presentation of scholarships and awards. I do wish we were all together in person so that I could share this evening with you and celebrate your accomplishments with you. As members of the National Honor Society, you have been previously recognized for your leadership, scholarship, character, and service. I admire each of you for the hard work and dedication that you have demonstrated to be here this evening, being honored for your accomplishments in the classroom. Your achievements speak not only to your investment in your learning, but in the support you have received from your parents, family members, and your teachers along the way. Congratulations to everyone being recognized this evening. I wish you nothing but the very best in all of your future endeavors. Thank you.
And now to present our awards. The Brown University Book Award is presented to a junior who exhibits excellent verbal and written communication skills. I am pleased to present the Brown University Book Award to Aaron Ferrer. The Harvard Prize Book Award. The Harvard Prize Book Award is awarded to an outstanding high school student in the junior year who demonstrates academic excellence and outstanding character combined with achievement in extracurricular activities. I am pleased to present the Harvard Prize Book Award to Jared Silverman. The St. Michael's College Book Award for Academic Achievement and Social Conscience recognizes outstanding students who demonstrate a strong commitment to volunteerism and leadership in their communities. I am pleased to present the St. Michael's College Book Awards to Isabella Rocha and Aiden Carpets.
The University of Pennsylvania Book Award is given to a junior who exemplary citizenship and community service. I am pleased to present the University of Pennsylvania Book Award to Savannah Rose. The Suffolk University Book Award is given to a student who exemplifies a commitment to their education and school community. I am pleased to present the Suffolk University Book Award to Chloe Dola.
At this time, we would like to introduce Mr. Matthew Talbot, Science Content Coordinator, and Mrs. Alice Ferris, Social Studies Content Coordinator, to present some awards.
The Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute Award is granted to one of the world's most finest technological universities. We're proud to recognize the achievements of an outstanding science and math student in the junior class. A minimum $1,000 scholarship is awarded to this student should she pursue study at Rensselaer and qualifies for the scholarship. I am pleased to award the Rensselaer Medal to Amelia Delano Batella. The Bosch and Lomb Award is presented to a junior in recognition of outstanding academic achievement and superior intellectual promise in the field of science. University of Rochester and Bosch and Lomb offer the recipient a scholarship of $30,000 over 4 years if she attends the university and qualifies for the scholarship. This year's Bosch and Lomb Award goes to Catherine Magdalene Corcoran. The George Eastman Young Leaders Award is presented to a junior in recognition of strong leadership experience at school and in the community. High grades, challenging courses, and extensive involvement in extracurricular activities. The University of Rochester and the Kodak Foundation offers the recipient of a scholarship over 4 years if she attends the university. This year's Eastman Young Award goes to Isabella Grace Rocha. The Xerox Award for Innovation and Information Technology is presented to a junior in recognition of a strong interest in innovation, technology, and a high level of achievement in this area, exposure to two new technologies outside the school, such as pursuing serious work opportunities in local labs or industry, and leading other students to new approaches to old problems and best uses of communication tools. The University of Rochester and the Xerox Corporation offers a recipient a scholarship over 4 years if he or she attends the university. This year's Xerox Award for Innovation and Information Technology goes to Savannah Fay Rose. The Air Force Award is given to a top senior student in math and science. And this year's Air Force Award is given to Mark Robert Gagliardi. The Donald J. McNamara Award for the Excellence in Effort in Physics is presented to the most outstanding senior physics student at Somerset Berkley Regional High School. Don McNamara was a beloved physics teacher at our former Somerset High School, and his motto, "It's all physics," still resonates throughout the science department. This year's award goes to Andrew Thomas Willett. The Joanne Sylvia Award for Excellence in Effort in Biology is presented to the most outstanding senior AP Biology student at Somerset Berkley Regional High School. What made this student the perfect candidate for this award was academic achievement in science for all 4 years, exceptional laboratory skills, and excellent attitude towards learning in AP Biology. It's an honor to present this award to Jerome Clark Ross. The Diane J. Paskowski Award for Excellence in Effort in Chemistry is presented to the most outstanding senior AP Chemistry student at Somerset Berkley Regional High School. What made this student the perfect candidate for the award was academic achievement in science for all 4 years, exceptional laboratory skills, and excellent attitude towards learning in AP Chemistry. It's an honor to present this award to Clayton Jonathan Hopper. The Deborah L. Machado Award for Effort and Excellence in STEM and Innovation Pathways is presented to an outstanding senior STEM student at Somerset Berkley Regional High School. This award is named in honor of Deborah Machado, who is a longtime science educator and faculty member at Durfee, Somerset, and Somerset Berkley Regional High School. What made this student the perfect candidate, again, was the diversity in academic achievement in STEM classes for all 4 years, and in innovation pathways in problem solving outside the box. It is an honor to present this award to Madeline May Johnson. The Anatomy and Physiology Achievement Award is presented to the most outstanding senior anatomy and physiology student at Somerset Berkley Regional High School. It's an honor to present this award to Jada Lynn Matos. The Environmental Science Achievement and Stewardship Awards are presented to the most outstanding senior environmental science student at Somerset Berkley Regional High School. What made these students the perfect candidates for the award were academic achievement, exceptional laboratory skills, great classroom contributions, and excellent attitudes towards learning. It's an honor to present this award to Mary Kate Moreau, Elizabeth Mary Newman, and Alexander Cavado. Thank you.
The William Shakespeare Award for Academic Excellence in Advanced Placement Literature. Over the course of the school year, the following three students have truly excelled in advanced placement literature and composition. They have consistently impressed us with their ability to analyze literature in order to examine the human condition. Shakespeare once wrote, "We know what we are, but know not what we may be." They are exemplary readers, writers, and thinkers. Skills that will allow them to be anything they desire. Skills that have earned them the William Shakespeare Award for Academic Excellence in AP Literature and Composition. It is an honor to present this award to Amelia Batella, Abigail Matos, and Jeremy Russ. The Frederick Douglass and Susan B. Anthony Award is presented to a student who has demonstrated leadership, shown a commitment and understanding of social issues, and achieved academic excellence in history and the social sciences. This outstanding student exemplifies these qualities and has taken a rigorous course program. She is very motivated, and on behalf of the Social Studies Department, I am honored to present the Frederick Douglass and Susan B. Anthony Award to Amelia Botello. The Excellence in AP Psychology Award is presented to a student who has demonstrated outstanding college-level achievement through their performance and participation in AP Psychology. On behalf of Mr. Raymond McDonald and myself, I am honored to present the Excellence in AP Psychology Award to Jacob Mylan. The Excellence in AP United States History Award is presented to a student who has demonstrated outstanding college-level achievement through their performance and participation in AP United States History. On behalf of Mr. Mitchell Petty, Mr. Matthew Dion, and myself, I am honored to present the Excellence in AP United States History Award to Mark Gagliardi and Alex Millar. The Excellence in AP World History Award is presented to a student who has demonstrated outstanding college-level achievement through their performance and participation in AP World History. On behalf of Mr. Jack Pereira and myself, I am honored to present the Excellence in AP World History to Joseph Bodner. The Excellence in AP European History Award is presented to a student who has demonstrated outstanding college-level achievement through their performance and participation in AP European History. I am honored to present the Excellence in AP European History Award to Elizabeth Newman. The Excellence in AP History Award is presented to a student who has enrolled in and completed the AP US History, World History, and European History courses, and they have achieved academic excellence. This highly motivated student has shown her dedication, her commitment, and her outstanding level of achievement through her performance and participation in these courses. The Excellence in AP History Award goes to Sarah Callis. The Excellence in History and Social Science Award is presented to a student who is enrolled in and completed 4 years of history and social science coursework and achieved academic excellence. This highly motivated student has an excellent work ethic, who has shown her passion of history and social science, and has demonstrated outstanding college-level achievement through her performance in an AP program and her additional honors social science courses. On behalf of the Social Studies Department, I am honored to present the Excellence in History and Social Science Award to Allison Vieira. The DECA Business Award. This is a merit-based scholarship awarded to a grade 12 student who must have participated in DECA and recognized for a significant interest and excellence in the program. I am pleased to present the DECA Book Award to Grace Siddell and Elizabeth Ramos.
And now we'd like to reintroduce Ms. Erica Pereira and Ms. Jocelyn Farias, co-advisors of the National Honor Society.
As the co-advisor of the National Honor Society, it is my pleasure to also present the award for the World Language Department, as I am also the content coordinator. We have three awards this evening. The first is going to an outstanding junior in Portuguese. The student is Nathan Costa. Our next award for outstanding achievement in Spanish goes to Madeline Johnson. And our final award this year is given to a senior who is a student in our Spanish 4 program as well as starting with our Portuguese program. And that student is Avery Gluchaki. We will now continue with our award and scholarship recipients. The Somerset Teachers Association Presidential Scholarship Award is presented this evening to Tate Copeland. The Somerset Teachers Association Scholarship Award is also presented to Riley Diffley. The Somerset Teachers Executive Board Scholarship is presented to Jackson LePage. The South Elementary School Cricket Scholarship. This scholarship is presented to a senior who is furthering their education and who has attended South Elementary School for at least 4 years. On behalf of the South School PTO, I am pleased to present the South Elementary School Cricket Scholarship to Ashley Kang. The F. Robert Lang Scholarship is presented to a senior who has attended Wilbur Elementary School for at least 2 years, participated in community service, and ranked in the top 49th percentile of the graduating class. It is my pleasure on behalf of the South School PTO to present this scholarship to Allison Vieira.
The Irene Fortin Scholarship is presented to a senior who has attended North Elementary for at least 4 years. I am pleased to present this scholarship to Mark Gagliotti and Grace Doobie. The Marine Corps League Lieutenant Corporal John J. Van Gysen Detachment 1285 Scholarship. The Marine Corps League is presenting this scholarship in memory of Lance Corporal John J. Van Gysen, who was killed on July 5, 2004 in Iraq while serving in the Marine Corps. We present 4 scholarships annually to students whose family members were veterans. This is our way of giving back to veterans and their families. This year's recipient of the Marine Corps League, Lieutenant Corporal John J. Van Gysen Detachment 1285 Scholarship, is presented to Ashley Masick.
Work off the no energy of the audience, so we are trying our best. So right now, you know, Senora would be screaming and shouting for all of you. I'm really sorry because I love giving out money, so it's a little bland, but we're doing our best. This award, the James P. LeCompte Memorial Scholarship, is given to a student by demonstrating strength of integrity and character, has earned the respect of the faculty and students of Somerset Berkley Regional High School. This student has exemplified the traits of a real leader and a person we believe will continue to make Somerset Berkley proud. I am pleased to present this award to Madison LeConte. The Dorvalino Uliterio Memorial Scholarship. Dorvalino Uliterio was a Somerset resident for over 50 years. When he was not spending time with his family, he could easily be found at a nearby sporting event, usually on the soccer field as a referee. His love for youth sports was undeniable, which is why we created this scholarship on his behalf to help two athletes from Somerset Berkeley's 2020 graduating class with their future academic endeavors. Thank you to all the seniors who submitted an application. It was not an easy pick by any means. Congratulations to our two recipients this year, Rachel Ochoa and Owen Santos. The Somerset High School Class of 1960 scholarship is presented to a senior who is continuing their education at an institution of higher learning and have been involved in extracurricular activities and community service. The recipient of the Class of 1960 scholarship is awarded to Austin Schultz. The Somerset High School Class of 1961 scholarship is presented to a senior who is continuing their education after graduation. The recipient of the Class of 1961 scholarship is Owen Santos and Lindsay Aruda.
The Somerset Berkley Regional High School Class of 2015 scholarship is presented to a senior who intends to attend a 2 or 4 year degree college. I am pleased to present this scholarship award to Bryce Gerritsen. The Somerset Berkley Regional High School Class of 2017 scholarship is presented to a senior who will be continuing their education at an institution of higher learning and have been involved in extracurricular activities or community service. It is our honor to present this scholarship award to Adam Oman. The Somerset Berkley Regional High School Class of 2019 scholarship is presented in memory of Christian Kudo and Devin Crosby. This recipient of the Class of 2019 scholarship is awarded to Joel Macchielli. Somerset Insurance Underwriters Association scholarships, the recipients of the Somerset Insurance Underwriters Association scholarships are presented to Rachel Ochoa and Veronica Labanca.
The Joseph Viveris J. Insurance Agency Scholarship. This scholarship is presented to a senior who intends to pursue a 2 or 4 year degree in the field of marketing, finance, or business management. It is our pleasure to present this award to Alexis Kupis and Justin Tri. The Virginia Mullins Medical Field Scholarship. The Virginia Mullins Medical Field Scholarship is awarded to a student that is continuing their education at an institute of higher learning majoring in the medical profession. It is our pleasure to present the Virginia Mullins Medical Field Scholarship to Caroline Gajewski. The Somerset PM Women's Club Scholarship is awarded to a student who has demonstrated academic excellence in community or civic service. This year's Somerset PM Women's Club Scholarship recipient is Madeline Johnson. The Officer BJ Voss Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship is presented in memory of the life and legacy of Officer B.J. Voss, who was a Somerset police officer. The recipient of the Officer B.J. Voss Memorial Scholarship is Jessica Salamoni. The Marilyn Souza Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship is in memory of Marilyn Souza and is awarded to Elizabeth Newman and Madeline Johnson.
The Charles Mendes Jr. Scholarship Fund is pleased to announce the recipient of this year's scholarship is Elizabeth Newman. William L. White III Excellence in Education Scholarship. It is with a deep sense of respect and pride that the Friends of Buddy White present to you, Jillian Platt, the William L. White III Excellence in Education Scholarship. This award honors the memory of our dearest friend who taught for the Somerset School Department, for over 35 years. Known to his family and friends as Buddy, he often claimed that he had the greatest job in the world, teaching physical education in Somerset. What he never said, but what we all knew, was that he was one of the greatest teachers in the world. Buddy didn't simply teach a game, he taught sportsmanship, etiquette, grace, spirited fun, and oh yes, a language of the month, sprinkled into his lesson plans that included Spanish, French, German, Chinese, Japanese, just to name a few. Buddy was also an exemplary colleague. Mr. Robert Brochu, who you may remember, shared a small office space with Mr. White for over 30 years. Mr. Brochu recalls he never had a disagreement or a cross word with Buddy. He was simply a great guy, a kind and considerate person every day. So today, as we present you with the William L. White Excellence in Education Award, we wish for you three things: that you always believe you have the greatest job in the world, that you go the extra mile for your students, that your colleagues consider it an honor and a privilege to work side by side with you. Jillian Platt, congratulations on your graduation from Somerset Berkley Regional High School's class of 2020, and all the best as you begin this exciting chapter in your educational pursuits.
As we continue with the program, we'd also just like to remind everyone that normally we would have all of these people here tonight with us to speak on their own behalf and to hand out the scholarship money for their family members. And we know that it's very difficult for them not to be able to do so this evening because they really enjoy being able to hand out such wonderful gifts to all of you. So we just would like you to know that when we are reading words that they have submitted to us and on their behalf for their family members and colleagues. The Mason J. Stern Memorial Scholarship. We have chosen you, Abigail, to be the recipient of the Mason J. Stern Memorial Scholarship for demonstrating kindness. Mason was always very kind. He could carry on conversations with anyone and always put a smile on even a stranger's face. He loved soccer and he was very wise beyond his years. You have learned early in life pure kindness through the children's eyes and sound like you are wise beyond your years as well. Your essay resonated with us for all of these reasons. Good luck to you in your endeavors in the future. You will certainly have a positive impact in the world. We have chosen you, Owen, to be the recipient of the Mason J. Stern Memorial Scholarship for majoring in engineering. My husband and our family, as well as yours, have similar roots as far as hard work and engineering backgrounds. Even at 6 years old, Mason kept up outside with his dad and was always smart and willing to work very hard. His dad had him trained when someone asked him what he wanted to be when he was older. His response was always an electrical engineer. You have great things to look forward to. Good luck in your future. The recipients of the Mason J. Stern Memorial Scholarship are Abigail Trask and Owen Santos. The GFWC Taunton and Rainham Women's Club Award Scholarship, the recipient this year is Kaylee Visparis. The Joseph G. Palmyra Burns Memorial Scholarship for the class of 2020 is presented to Lindsay Aruda, Jonathan Cabral, Tiago João de T. Silva.
The College of the Holy Cross Magis Scholarship. Magis Scholarship recipients are among the most talented applicants to Holy Cross each year and have distinguished themselves in their school and community as top scholars, model citizens, and leaders. Magis, Latin for more, reflects the Jesuit invitation to dig deeper, pursue excellence, and allow space for attentiveness. And we are confident that the Magis Scholarship recipients will embrace that ideal and make the most of the gifts and opportunities with which they have been blessed. Magis Scholarships are
renewed each year for 4 years. The recipient of this prestigious award is Jacob Milan. The Coca-Cola Scholarship Foundation Award. Lindsay was one of 150 students across the country to be chosen as the 2020 Coca-Cola Scholar out of over 93 applications. We are honored to present this year's Coca-Cola Foundation Award to Lindsay Aruda. The AXA Achievement Scholarship. We are pleased to announce the recipient of this year's scholarship is Lindsay Aruda. The DAR Good Citizenship Award is presented to a senior who demonstrates dependability, service, leadership, and patriotism. This year's recipient of the DAR Good Citizenship Award is Caroline Gajewski. And Mrs. Pereira, I'll need your assistance right now.
Sure. So now we have our National Honor Society scholarships. Normally, we present these and we have Mrs. Schoonover pull out of a hat or something like that. So right now, since we're socially distanced, we'll do our best to add a little excitement and surprise. Do I picking one and you're picking?
Yep.
Okay.
And these are done completely at random.
And we have evidence of this right now since it is live. Elizabeth Newman.
Madison Fiola.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
And next we will return the program over to Mrs. Jacuto and Dr. Brelsford as they will present the Presidential Academic Fitness Awards and they will lead into our graduation awards and our graduation scholarships.
President's Academic Fitness Award is presented in recognition of outstanding academic achievement. The gold awards are presented to Lindsay Aruda, Joseph Bodner, Mark Gagliardi, Thomas Goodwin, Clayton Harper, Madeline Johnson, Jacob Milan, Rachel Ochoa, Andrew Ouellette, and Jeremy Russ.
The silver awards are presented to Grace Duby, Carolyn Kajewski, Alex Millar, Mary Kate Morrow, Caitlin Marrera, Adam Oman, Jillian Platt, Jessica Salamone, Austin Schultz, and Allison Vieira.
The next group of awards are the presentation of the graduation awards. Traditionally, these awards are handed out on graduation and will continue to be handed out on our graduation ceremony on August 7th. However, because these are scholarships, we decided to include them in tonight's presentation so that the recipients can receive their scholarship money at the intended traditional time of this week. The Superintendent's Award for the Highest Ranking Student. This award is given to the highest ranking senior. This award is based upon scholarship, loyalty, and achievement. This year's recipient of the Superintendent's Award for the Highest Ranking Student is Jacob Milan, attending the College of the Holy Cross. Citizenship Certificate presented by the Warren S. Hathaway Post Number 228. The Citizenship Award presented to the boy or girl in the graduating class who is outstanding in character, citizenship, and scholarship is presented by the Warren S. Hathaway Post Number 228 American Legion. The recipient of this year's award goes to Abigail Traz, attending the University of Rhode Island. The Reginald Pelagio Education Academic Excellence Award. This award is given in memory of longtime Business Technology Department Chairperson Reginald Pelagio. The award is presented annually to the student in the graduating class who has attained the highest scholastic rank of all Somerset Berkley Regional High School Business Technology students. This year's award recipient is Amber Holt, attending the University of Massachusetts, Dartmouth. the Winifred Medeiros Raiders Turf Spirit Award. This award is given in memory of former Business Technology Department teacher Winifred Medeiros. It is awarded to the student in the graduating class who has demonstrated leadership in retail merchandising as a contributing member of the Somerset Berkley Regional High School store team. The recipient of the 2020 Winifred Medeiros Raider Turf Spirit Award is presented to Roy McComb, attending the University of Massachusetts, Dartmouth. The Donald J. McNamara Memorial Scholarship. Mr. Donald J. McNamara was a science teacher who enjoyed teaching physics at Somerset High School from 1970 until his death in 1997. During his 27-year career, Mr. McNamara contributed in many other ways to the Somerset schools, including serving as a science curriculum specialist, co-advisor to the school newspaper, a member of the PTA, and as a teacher for the Somerset's Gifted and Talented program. He coached girls' softball, developed computer software curricula projects, designed toys, and served as a visiting professor at Bridgewater State University. Mr. McNamara served as consultant to the South Coast Educational Collaborative Computer Technology Center and as a technical skills instructor for Texas Instrument. Mr. McNamara received many awards and much recognition for his endeavors. In addition, he found time to be a dedicated family man, master carpenter, and a person who always found time to help others in many varied projects. A dedicated, compassionate, energetic, and passionate person, Mr. McNamara inspired all who knew him. This four-year renewable scholarship is presented to Mark Gagliardi, attending Worcester Polytechnic Institute.
The Raymond McDonald Jr. Memorial Scholarship. Mr. McDonald was a mathematics teacher at Somerset High School from 1964 until his death in 1990. In addition to his teaching duties, he served as Somerset's head football coach from 1971 to 1986. He instituted the recognition ceremony as part of his efforts to inspire Somerset High School and now Somerset Berkley Regional High School students to contribute towards the betterment of their school community. For more than a quarter of a century, Mr. McDonald dedicated himself to instilling the values in his students that would foster their development as capable, productive, and ethical members of society. A kind and sincere gentleman, he never tired of encouraging his students to strive towards achievement of their individual potential. The scholarship was awarded to Fiona Lyons, attending Curry College. Carl W. McDermott Scholarship. This is the 33rd presentation of an annual scholarship that will be offered to a member of the graduating class who best exemplifies combined academic excellence and commitment to co-curricular activities through his or her secondary years. This scholarship is presented to Molly Sullivan, attending Nova Southeastern University. The Somerset Berkley Regional High School PTO Scholarship goes to the 2020 graduating students who parent or parents have actively participated as a member of the Somerset Berkley Regional High School Parent Teacher Organization during the student's high school years. The graduating students must also intend to future his or her education. This year, the PTO scholarship awards go to three students: Brian Canuse, attending the University of Massachusetts Amherst; Ashley Masick, attending Merrimack College; and Austin Masick, attending the University of Massachusetts Dartmouth.
The Blue Raider Pride Scholarship. The Blue Raider Pride Scholarship is voted on by the staff of Somerset Berkley Regional High School. It is awarded to the student that the teachers and staff believe best represents the values and beliefs of a Somerset Berkley graduate. We are pleased and honored to award the Blue Raider Pride Scholarship to Carolyn Gajewski, attending the University of Tampa. And finally, I am pleased and honored to present to you the top 10 students of Somerset Berkley Regional High School. Ranked 10th in his class and attending Tufts University, Joseph Bodner. Number 9, attending Quinnipiac University, Madeline Johnson. Ranked number 8, attending Providence College, Lindsay Aruda. Number 7, attending Boston University, Jeremy Russ. Number 6, attending Wentworth Institute of Technology, Clayton Harper. Number 5, attending Northeastern University, Thomas Goodwin. Ranked number 4, attending Worcester Polytechnic Institute, Mark Gagliardi. Number 3, attending Northeastern University, Rachel Ochoa. The salutatorian of the class of 2020, attending the University of Massachusetts Lowell, Andrew Ouellette. And finally, the valedictorian of the class of 2020, attending the College of the Holy Cross, Jacob Milan. Congratulations to you all. For closing remarks, we would like to reintroduce Mrs. Erica Pereira and Mrs. Jocelyn Farias.
Before we continue with our closing remarks and thank yous, we would also like to present the honor cords at this time virtually. Normally, you would be coming up on stage and receiving your honor cord, which you received this week during our cap and gown distribution. So we have no problem at all for you right now in your living room or wherever you are to put your cap and gown on, your cord, your NHS tassel, snap us a photo, send it to Dr. Brelsford so she can tweet it out, and we are going to go through our list of all of our NHS members, and here we go. I'll start from the first half. Okay, sure. Brandon Almeida, Brian Alves, Adelaide Andrade, Lindsay Aruda, Mason Aruda, Dylan Belcher, Jack Benfado, Joseph Bodner, Jonathan Cabral, Sarah Callis, Jacob Carpenter, Andrew Caruso, Riley Diffley, Holly Dion, Grace Doobie, Luke Doobie, David Ferreira, Madison Fiola, Mark Gagliardi, Jocelyn Gagnon, Caroline Gajewski, Bryce Garrettson, Thomas Goodwin, Jolene Girard, Clayton Harper, Matthew Hinvis, Amber Holt, Allie Jackson, Madeline Johnson, Brian Canoos, Alexis Kupis, Veronica Labanca,
Sydney Ledger, Alyssa Lavasser, Fiona Lyons, Ashley Masick, Austin Masick, Laura Medeiros, Alexis Melvin, Jacob Milan, Alex Millar, Mary Kate Moreau, Kaitin Marrera, Andrew Morin, Elizabeth Newman, Rachel Ochoa, Adam Oman, Caitlin Oliveira, Andrew Ouellette, Madison Pierce, Jillian Platt, Elizabeth Ramos, Jacqueline Rosario, Jeremy Russ, Jessica Salamone, Owen Santos, Austin Schultz, Janie Sylvia, Nicholas Taylor, Abigail Trace, Brielle Tripp, Zachary Valiente, Allison Vieira, and Kaylee Visvaris. Congratulations to each and every one of you.
Even though this evening you were not here with us to receive your scholarship award or money from our presenters, we would really hope that you could take some time, take a photo of yourself, because I know they normally would love to come down and take a photo with you with the award. All of those presenters had taken the time to send us in their words, and obviously you'll be getting your award in the mail. So if you would take a photo of yourself dressed up, a nice thank you letter or a card to them would really, really be appreciated on behalf of the National Honor Society as in our administration. And Mrs. Farias will now have our special thanks.
Special thanks. It takes a lot of people to put this whole thing together for this evening, and it's always very exciting. It takes several months at least to do so. Special thanks to Mrs. Coogan. She's Director of Student Learning. Mrs. Rhonda O'Connell, Administrative Assistant. She's my right hand. We worked back and forth for weeks upon end, getting the program together. This year, the script in addition, this is all new. I've been doing this a number of years now on, you know, a TV broadcast. Ms. Belshe, Mr. Belshe, Superintendent Schoonover, we couldn't do it without you as well. Your support is, and the school committee, we appreciate all that you do for us. Mr. Talbot, Mrs. Ferris, who are here today, our National Honor Society president this year, Bryce Gerritsen, who helped us with his speech this morning. Thank you all for making this event possible. We miss each and every one of you and wish you all the absolute best in your future.
We will see you Friday night for the graduation parade, safely in your vehicles as a passenger, as Dr. Brelsford asked you so kindly. And I will high five my co-advisor from across the sky and all of you. I wish you the best
thank
of
you.
Luck. And don't forget to reach out and say thank you to the presenters. Be kind and stay safe.
Thank you.